May every youth cry well a day. Her name was Barbary Ellen. T'was in the merry month of May, when the green buds were swelling, sweet William on his deathbed lay, for the love of Barbary Ellen. He sent his servant to the town, to the place where she was dwelling. Said, Master bids you come for him, if your name be Barbary Ellen. And slowly, slowly got she up, slowly went she nigh him, and as she drew the curtains back, young man, I think you're dying. Oh yes, I'm low, I'm very low, never shall be better until I have the love of one whose name be Barbary Ellen. Oh yes, your love, you're very low, and you never shall be better, for you shall not have the love you want. No, you shan't have Barbary Ellen. And softly skipped she down the stairs, wept he like a willow. 'Tis vain in vain, my dear young man, to home for Barbary Ellen. He turned his pale face to the wall, for death was in him burning. Goodbye, kind friends and kinfolk all, be kind to Barbary Ellen. And she did pass the wooded fields, she heard a death bell knelling, and every stroke it spoke her name, hard-hearted Barbary Ellen. The more she heard, the more she grieved, until she burst out crying, oh, bear his own, please take him away, for I am now a dying. Oh, mother dear, go make my bed, go make it soft and narrow, Young William died for me today. I'll die for him tomorrow. Oh, Father dear, go dig my grave. Dig it deep and narrow. Sweet William died for love of me, and I shall die of sorrow. They buried her in the old churchyard. Sweet William lay aside her, and from his grave grew a red, red rose, and from hers grew a briar. They grew themselves up the old church wall, till they could grow no higher, and they grew into a lover's bind. The red rose and the briar. In Scarlet Town, where I was born, there was a fair maid dwelling, made every boy cry well-a-day, and her name was Barbary Ellen.